infinite series, or simply we say series. So we have considered the concept of sequence. Now we want to consider the concept of infinite series. So we define infinite series as follows. So we say that if this an is a sequence, as you have known, then a1 plus a2 plus this up to infinity is called infinite series, or simply we call it a series. This simply means that sum of all the terms in a sequence is called a series, or we call it infinite series. So this is how we write series. We write it in a closed form like this: summation n runs from 1 to infinity an. Or conveniently, we just write summation an, which is the same thing as this. So we use s to represent everything. So this is how we write infinite series. Another important of infinite series is partial sum. So we consider the following sequence of partial sum. If they say that partial sum, the sum of the first n term of a series is called the partial sum. So you can find the sum of the first n term of a series. For instance, if you consider the arithmetic series and the geometric series, the AP and GP. So you know we normally find sum of the first n term there. So that sum of the first n term that we found there is called partial sum. So in that case, we normally write the first sum to be the first term, A1. S2, which is the second sum, will be A1 plus A2. That is first term and second term, like that. Sn will be A1 plus A2 up to An. So if they now say that the sequence of partial sum, the sequence of partial sum will be written in this form. So this is the sequence of partial sum. So that is the first one, this one, this one, and we know what this one means. S1 means A1. S2 means A1 plus A2, like that. And we know that A1, all this A, they are the terms of this sequence or of this series here. So an example of partial sum is this. Sn is equal to this. So this is for AP. Also, our Sn is equal to this, and that is for GP. You know, this is sum of the first n term of AP. What is sum of the first n term of GP? So they are closest examples of the sequence of they are closest example of partial sum. Take for instance. So let's take for instance, let's assume that we have this series. So this series can be written in this form, 3 over 10 raised to power n. Now you observe that our a is 3 over 10 here, and our common ratio, which is our hand, is this one divided by this one. That is 3 over 10 square divided by 3 over 10. So this is 1 over 10. So we know that the sequence of the partial sum, when we apply this, so will now be our A is 3 over 10 into 1 minus R raised to power n. So this is our R, 1 over 10 raised to power n over 1 minus R. And our R is 1 over 10. So from this list, if we simplify it, so we are going to have this 1 minus 1 over 10 raised to power n. That is when we simplify this thing further. So we are going to have this. So this is the partial sum of this. So from this place, if we decide to take limit here, as n tends to infinity of this Sn, if I take the limit 1 over 3, 1 this, at the end of the day, you are going to have this 1 over 3, 1 minus, this one will be 0, because 1 over 10 is less than 1. And if you put n tends to infinity, n to be 1 over 10 is super infinity, will be 0. Any number a raised to power infinity will be 0 if a is less than 1, and if it is in between this and it's also greater than 0. So from this list, our answer is 1 over 3 is the limit here. So this 1 over 3 here is the sum of this series here. So we see that 1 over 3 is a sum of the series. So what that simply means is that the series that we are talking about, 3 over 10 raised to the power n, n runs from 1 to infinity, this one is equal to 1 over 3, which is our s. Goes to another interesting one, which we call convergence of series. Convergence of series. Now, we divide it as follows. We say that an infinite series, this, is said to be convergent if the sequence of the partial sum converges. So what that simply means is that if what this thing simply means by definition of convergence, you know, we say that a sequence converges if the limit exists with what we have said in our previous class. Now, if they say that sequence of the partial sum converges, what that simply means is that if we can find a partial sum this, and we can find the limit, and if the limit exists, then we say that the series converges. So that is what this statement means, that an infinite series is said to be convergent if the sequence of the partial sum converges. That is, we say that that is what we have written here. A series this converges to a sum s if the limit is equal to x. Just like the example we gave the other time, this example here, you know that here we were able to find the partial sum here, and we found the limit, and it gives us 1 over 3. So that means we say that this series converges to 1 over 3. So that is what, 1 over 3, we call it the sum of the series. That is why we said that it converges to a sum s if the limit of that partial sum is equal to x. Now, a sequence that is not convergent is said to be divergent. So we have given example, and generally for GP, see that generally a GP is convergent if absolute value of the common ratio is less than 1. So that is, if your hag is a, if you take the absolute value of your common ratio and it's still less than 1, then we see that the sequence, the series converges. So we have used a GP, a geometric series, as an example. So a geometric series as an example. An important question: show that this series converges. Hence, find the sum. So solution, in fact, this series we normally call it a telescopic series. Now, let us represent the series as follows. Sn equal to this, be a partial sum. Our aim is to find the partial sum here. That is, we want to find the sum of the first n term of this. You know, this thing is same thing as what we have here. That is, when n is 1, 1 plus 4 is 5. 1 plus 5 is 6. That is why we have 5 times 6. Thus, when n is 2, 1 plus 2, 2 plus 4 is 6. 2 plus 5 is 7. Like that. To be going like that, we call it a telescopic series. Now, how do we find the sum of the partial sum of a telescopic series? What we do is we need to consider this function that is here, which is 1 over m4 plus this. Now, the knowledge of a partial fraction is needed here. So we need to find the partial fraction of this thing. So if you find the partial fraction, which I believe you are familiar with, you are going to have 1 over this minus 1 over n plus 5. If you resolve this thing into partial fraction, so it's a thing you can verify whether this one is equal to this. That simply means that 1 over 5 times 6 will be equal to 1 over 5 minus 1 over 6. 1 over 6 times 7 will simply be 1 over 6 times, minus 1 over 7, like that, like that, like that. So in that case, this Sn can be written as Sn equal to 1 over 5 minus this. Just like what I said the other time, it will be 1 over 5 minus 1 over 6 plus 1 over 6 minus 1 over 7, like that, until it gets to this place, until it gets to 1 over 4 minus 1 over n plus 5. And that is what we have here. You observe that this one is gone. This is gone. This one too will be gone. In fact, all of them will go except this last one and this first one. So that simply means that our Sn is equal to 1 over 5 minus 1 over n plus 5. So we have found the partial sum. So since you have found the partial sum, we cannot show that this partial sum, the sequence exists. So really, to show that the sequence exists, we really need to take the limit as n tends to infinity. So this will be limit. So we have taken the limit of both sides. We know that this one does not change, it's still 1 over 5. But this one as n tends to infinity, this one will give me, it will divide, remember how to find limit of n tends to infinity. You divide both sides by n. So as n tends to infinity, you are going to have 0 over 1 plus 0. So this will be 1 over 5 minus 0. So this is 1 over 5. So since the sequence exists, since the sequence converges to 1 over 5, so in that case, we cannot say that, therefore, the series converges. Hence, the sum is 1 over 5 because the sequence converges to 1 over 5. So in that case, the sum of the series will be 1 over 5. Another example, we want to show that this series converges. I want to find the sum. So let's start. So let us represent the partial sum by this. So we have only written what is here. So when we change the n to k, it's now k runs from 1 to n because it's a partial sum. So we can't consider to infinity again. So it is to n term. Now this thing can be written as this. This k will be k plus 1 minus 1, because what is there is just what is there, over k plus 1 factorial, which can be separated as k runs from 1 to n, k plus 1 over this minus 1 over this. But don't forget that k plus 1 factorial is same thing as k plus 1 times k factorial. This is just the normal knowledge of factorial. We know that n factorial means n into n minus 1. So if you now replace n by n minus 1 factorial, if you replace n by k plus 1, so you are going to arrive at this. So we are going to apply it here, and then this will be gone. And that will be equal to summation k runs from 1 to n. So this will just be 1 over k factorial, because this k plus 1 will cancel this k plus 1, minus 1 over k plus 1 factorial. So we now begin to put our k to be 1. And to n, this will be 1 factorial minus, this will be 2 factorial. When k is this, plus, when k is 2, it will be 1 over 2 factorial minus 1 over 3 factorial. That is 2 plus 1 is 3. That will be plus 1 over 3 factorial minus 1 over 4 factorial. It will be going like that until it gets to 1 over n factorial. That is when k is equal to n minus 1 over n plus 1 factorial. Now, if you look at that, our Sn will be 1 over 1 factorial. This and this will be gone, and this, in fact, and this, all of them will be gone. It will remain only this last one here. So that is minus 1 over n plus 1 factorial. So in order to now check whether this one is convergent or not, so So we take the limit of both sides and find the limit as n tends to infinity. So we have taken the limit of both sides. This one will be 1. And as usual, this will be 0 as n tends to infinity. So as we have done that before, so this is 1. So in that case, we can now see that the series converges and the sum is 1. Another important concept is divergent test for series. Now let's consider a series this. Now if you find out that limit as n tends to infinity of that an is not equal to 0, then we'll say that the series diverges. So this is a test for divergence. So it's just to take the limit and you find out that the limit is not infinity. Sorry, it's not equal to 0. But this series does not guarantee us to know whether a series converges or not. Because at times, even if limit of n tends to infinity, a n is equal to 0, at times it may even diverge. So that is the reason why I say it does not guarantee. So it's only guaranteed for divergence that if the limit is not equal to 0, it is divergent. But if it is equal to 0, it may diverge and it may not diverge. So that is the reason why we can't confirm that. But if you look at our previous examples on how to show that series converges, you see that we first find our SN, which is partial sum. Then we find the limit. If it exists, we see that it converges. But unfortunately, it is not all series that we can find its limit. It's not a series that we can find the limit, that we can find its partial sum. So there are some series, there are many series that we can't find their partial sum. In that case, this method may not work. So we now apply what we call test of convergence. So it will lead us to the following test of convergence. Test of convergence. As we have said, that the formal way of testing that a series converges is not always the case, because there are many series that we can't find their partial sum. So in that case, we use the following test of convergence. The first of them, integral test. We use this integral test to test that a series converges or not. Now we say that suppose f of x is continuous, it's positive, and it's monotone for s is greater than or equal to 1, such that f of n is equal to this a n, then this series here is convergent or divergent according as this integral exists or not. What that simply means is that if this integral exists, then we say that it is convergent. If the integral does not exist, we say that it is divergent. That is mean of according as this exists or not. That is, if exists, we say it is convergent. If does not, we say it is divergent. So let's take the following examples. Example, test for the convergence or divergence of the following series by using integral test. So this is the series. So the first thing is, let us recognize our an, which is this. So therefore, our f of x will be equal to 1 over, you turn that n to x. So now show that this converges. So we find the integral, whatever that is here, 1 to infinity. F of x, dx. So this will be integral 1 to infinity. Our f of x is x squared plus 1 dx. Now from this place, we integrate. And when we integrate this, we have arctan x. This is 1 to infinity. And that will give me arctan infinity minus arctan 1. But we know that arctan infinity is pi over 2. And arctan 1 will give us pi over 4. So this will give us certain value, which is pi over 4. So you see that the integral exists. So therefore, we cannot say that this series converges. I will write, since the integral exists, then the series converges. So that is what the test is saying. So another example. So this is another example here. So here our an is 1 over n. Our f of x will be 1 over x. Therefore, this f of x will be equal dx. Will now be equal to 1 to infinity. This is 1 over x dx. And when we integrate this, we have ln x 1 to infinity. So this will be ln infinity minus ln 1. So ln infinity is infinity. Ln 1 is 0. So this will be infinity. So this does not exist. So we cannot say that since the integral does not exist, then this series diverges, or we simply say does not converge. So say since it does not exist, then it diverges, or you just say that it does not converge. So you can consider this as an exercise. So you test for the convergence using the integral test. So in our next video, so we are going to explain more on the test of convergence. We have only considered the first of them. So we'll consider the rest of them in the following, in our next class. Have a nice day.